I think goals for me, if I want my goals to be successful, I try to think about having some goals that are both short and long term. And long term ones usually would be more about my job or my career, my family. Personal ones might be just things that might be more fun for me, like reading more, exercising more. They need to be, for me, measurable, particularly if they have a number or something, a frequency in it. I think that helps me. I usually try to tell a couple of people, so my husband or good friend, that I'm trying to work on something for encouragement. Periodically kind of check your progress and make them, if it's something big, I try to make it into smaller steps so that I can see some intermediate progress before I get to the end of the big goal. So I try to tell them to break it down into smaller steps and look at the individual parts of it as they're working toward it. I also like to have some very small goals that I can complete on a daily basis, and I encourage them to do that too, because some days that's what you're able to contribute or to complete very small, small pieces of a goal. As you get older, I think maybe that is a little easier to do, in the sense that you are more realistic about what you personally are able to do and also what your life situation is at that point. I think for my children, that the more that we can help them and expose them to different experiences and people and situations, I think for my own particular family, that helps them in knowing what they might and might not be able to do. But I think that's a tough thing for a lot of us, and I know it is for our family, to be realistic about what you're able to do and what you're not. And the other thing is, maybe you're not able to do this one thing, but maybe there's something related, or something as you're exploring that, you realize, well, I can't do this, but I could do that. Or in speaking with this person, maybe this could substitute for that, or this has some of the parts of that goal or experience that I'm interested in. And sometimes that can help. It can open new doors that you might not have thought of before. I think for me, for goals to be successful, I need to, first of all, identify them. I need to write them down. I'm old enough that I like to see things in writing, and just the physical act of writing helps me with that.
In recent years, there has been a social network takeover on society. There are varying opinions on whether the effect has been positive or negative. On the bright side, people are able to advocate for good causes they believe in, like fundraisers. Also, there are social media sites that build a sense of empathy and togetherness. If you are suffering from a specific problem, such as cancer, you can find sites that show that you are not alone and that you can get through this. Unfortunately, social media can be detrimental to society. Cyberbullying is a large problem because people close to the victim can anonymously attack the person through social media, leading to depression and a sense of loneliness. Productivity also decreases. Whether it be at work or when you are just trying to finish a project, social media can be a large distraction. This is because it is easier to post selfies on Instagram than it is to use your time wisely and finish science fair. Overall, though, social media is a positive advent of the 21st century. It allows for more job opportunities, better communication, a sense of togetherness, and even money raised for the less fortunate. Hopefully, these negative qualities can be phased out throughout the next few years.